Послушай меня, еще не время.
Hi everyone, it's Rosanne. Welcome to my channel, to my new subbies. And I am here to share my design team project for Natasha's Scrapbook Corner. And I'm going to try to get through this as fast as I can. This is my design team project for January. And this is using all of the items that I got in my January design team package. And I don't know if it's anywhere close by or not, but I don't have the vintage spools, so I created my own spool out of chipboard, decoupaged music sheet paper, and paint, and then there's a aluminum foil roll on the inside, and I like to use those because they're a little bit smaller than a paper towel roll. But that's how I made my my spool, and then I put my little handmade by me that I stamped on some scrap pieces of material, and Natasha also has handmade labels in her store, all different types. So I added one of her handmade "Hope That You Will Be Happy" labels. On the top, I used my favorite image. It's three dress forms, and I actually use that in my mailing, my labels. If I can. Right now I don't have a printer, but I had this particular one that was just the picture, a huge picture of all three of those dress forms. Really gorgeous. And I just added some gold paint. I used some of the mesh bling all the way around the top. This is a gorgeous flower, a leather-like flower from Natasha's store, and it's got like gorgeous seed beads, and then this bling on the top there. This is some of her silk red flowers, and she sells these in her floral section. This was the beautiful applique that was given to me in my design team package, and this little beauty is one of her ribbons. She has lots of different styles of ribbons, and what I did was I used this one that had words and just cut out the word and then singed the edges, and then I used this ribbon that had butterflies, and I simply just cut out the butterfly and singed, fussy cut the butterfly and singed the edges. I also used some of her sequins there in the middle, and I used sequins all the way around the edge of the spool. So let me see if I can find the ribbons so that I can show you that. Well, this is my design team package, and the ribbons that I used are here. Now, I've been cutting these up for quite some time, so they are going to be a little bit tattered. But this is the ribbon that I used, and these are the butterflies. And I also used the word fly. And I'll show you that in a bit. But there you go. See, I just cut out the butterfly. And then this ribbon is the one that has all the words. And there's beauty. And all I did again was fussy cut the word out, and then you just singe the edges so it doesn't fray. So there's that. She has many, many, many ribbons. I also used this ribbon with the keys, and I cut out a key, and I'll show you that. And these were from past design team packages. Okay, I'm going to leave that there so I don't have to stall for time. I used some seam binding as a closure. And Natasha has many colors of seam binding in her store. I also used the gorgeous Eiffel Tower pin that she gave me. Gorgeous. These are the flowers. And I also sprayed this flower on the inside, and I'll show you that, and changed the color. But this is its natural, the natural color. She has many colors. And this is one of her hearts that was given to me in my design team package. And I'll go over ones of the flower. So let's do this. I'll just unravel, and now this is the outside of my roll. And so there's some of just some cheesecloth and some lace. This roll was hand sewn. I didn't use glue, maybe on one or two things, but for the most part it is hand sewn. This is Natasha's gorgeous little applique. And there's just some sewn on buttons, different types of laces, little bits, and some cheesecloth there at the end. And on the inside I used book paper. This is that aluminum foil roll, and then this is one of Natasha's gorgeous laces there on the inside. Okay, so then let's start at the beginning here. So you've seen the back side. This is the inside. I couldn't stop. I could have made this a mile long, because I think it took me 2 days. And once I got started, I just didn't want to stop. I just went crazy. And even sewing everything, as you can see, everything's hand sewn. I laid down bits of lace. This is Natasha's lace. And then I laid the seam binding down. I laid the medallion down. And then the bow on top. And then I sewed it all there together so that it's all together. Here's some of Natasha's bling mesh. And then I just started putting bits of laces. This is a scrap bit of a green kind of braid that I had for quite some time. And there's some just cut pieces of applique with this hand-sewn pearl. A little tiny bit of lace there. There is some of this fiber that I have that's tucked under with another piece of material on top. And everything, this is a little piece of a rosette there on the top. And that's some sequin leaves and a little tiny fleur-de-lis that I sewed on. And I even tacked on the sequins there, because it kept flipping around, and I didn't, even though I like the movement, I'm getting the movement from the little charm there. There's a button, and it's a P because my mom's name was Pauline, so this was from her goodies, and I actually made this to be a heritage piece. I have quite a lot of things that were from my mom in here, scraps of lace, and in fact, this was a little scrap of lace that was from my mom. And this is just a piece of napkin, torn up napkin, this piece. This is Natasha's bow. It's a rosette. There's, I don't know, just a piece of curtaining, a little flower, and you can see all the stitches there. There is the rosette. There's a little tiny butterfly there that I stitched. There's the key that I took from the Natasha's ribbon. And there's a leaf, kind of a leaf ribbon that I've had for a really long time. And I just did some embroidery. I didn't have embroidery thread, but I just used regular thread. And then I added the little beads. And then these were little flowers, flower applique that I added the beads to. This is a rosette on top of some mesh. This was a little teapot, and I strung the beads there. This was a little trinket in my mom's button box. Some vintage material here. This is some new material buttons that I've sewn on. This is Natasha's bling, and you can sew it on. Some applique. This is a piece of Natasha's cotton, her tiny cotton lace, and I just turned it into a tiny flower and sewed a bead in the center. There's some bead strand that I just sewed on there. These are little flower appliques that I got from Rosella quite some time ago. Wedding applique. This is one of my favorite wedding appliques that I tea-dyed. That's a bead cap and a bead. There is Natasha's little orange flower. See that orange flower? I just tea-dyed it, or sprayed it, rather. And there's the fly from Natasha's ribbon. And all of this is on top of a huge applique that it was a flower applique that I ended up covering. But there is the little butterfly, and it's sewn onto some cheesecloth. And this is just a little fiber that I had. I just sewed that on. This was a little, the word handmade, and that's from my label. Natasha's leaf. That's from my handmade by sign. I just cut it apart. That's a half of a flower. This was in my mom's button box. She had a bunch of different types of sequences on pins. And I think she used to use them to craft with, but you can see they're vintage. The silver is coming off. But I thought that was so cool. That's a little charm that I've had. This is a piece of trim that I think I got from Lisa's Paper Passion. That's a little charm that I've been holding on to for quite some time. It's a tiny little spool, and these are Natasha's buttons. Just some lace here, some more bits of lace there, everything hand sewn. There's another birdie from my handmade sign. There's a layer of lace on the bottom, and then this is a medallia. My mom had lots of medallias, and her faith was very strong, so that's her medallia. This is the little key set from Natasha's store. There's some mesh. This is a little piece of lace that I got from, I don't remember now. I don't know where I got that one from. That's the center of a doily, some buttons. I hand sewn the little pearls. This was in my mom's scrap or button box, and it's a bead. It's a metal bead. So I just sewed it on there. And when I saw Jeanette's snippet roll, I loved the fact that she put buttons underneath mesh. So I have taken that idea and added a button from Jeanette. Thank you, Jeanette. I love that idea. I wanted to do more of that kind of thing, add things under the mesh. But as you can see, I just was full of ideas, and I didn't have room. I wanted to just keep going. This is acrylic heart from Natasha's store. This is Natasha's pearl trim there on the top. So new and old goes perfectly together. You can see the new buttons mixed with the old vintage laces. It works perfectly. This is the other half of the rosette that I used in the beginning. This is Natasha's birdie. Some old scraggler piece of torn up lace, and then this is Natasha's lace here that I tea-dyed. It's just a pin that I put there. That is Natasha's applique piece with a little bling that, again, this was in my mom's scrap box. Oops. It's a little vintage bling. This is Natasha's lace down here that I layered. This is the bead spray that I took apart. And that would be doing this with one hand. Those bead sprays there. And I also took apart those little heart spray. So there's the bead spray. I just added some seed beads and sewn them on. And this is Natasha's lace up here. That's Natasha's flower that it was a blue flower that I sprayed green. This is just some scraggly scraps of lace. That's Natasha's applique there. This was a ribbon. Do I have it? Yeah. So this is the ribbon that I've had. And this was in my mom's scraps. And I just turned this ribbon into this flower. And by gathering it, and then I sewed the beads. There's Natasha's mesh bling. Those are the heart, acrylic hearts from the spray. And that's Natasha's lace with little hand-sewn beads. This is more of Natasha's lace down here. It's tea-dyed and mesh. This was some of the words, things of beauty, that was in that ribbon from Natasha's store. This was a flower that I've had for a really, really long time. I've been wanting to use it. I only had one, and this was a perfect place for it. And this flower was given to me by Natasha in our Christmas swap. This is the green flower that I paint, that I spray. We're almost to the end here. This is the green flower that I sprayed. See, it just changed the color. You can see on the bottom. This is a little hanger from Hanger Charm, also from Natasha's store. Applique. This is another little tiny scrap of Natasha's tea-dyed lace with a bunch of pearls sewn in the center. This is cheesecloth with Natasha's gorgeous pearl mesh or pearl bling mesh. That's her little heart, and I sewed a bunch of seed beads. That's a vintage button that was in my mom's button box that I sewed on. She loved pink also, pink and green. This was one of my mom's earrings that I just sewed on there. That is the bow from Natasha's store and the bling. And this bling you can sew on. I did sew that on. I don't know if you can see the threads there. Some more scrap laces. That's a rondelle from my mom's bling button box. Some of my favorite wedding dress. That's a stamped muslin. This is just a piece of lace that I gathered, and then I just embroidered some thread there and just kind of made little X's just to sew it on there. But I used black thread because there's black here. And then I found these snaps from my mom's button box, so I added the snaps there with all the black going on. And then I did a couple of zigzag threads. This also wears some metal, they're kind of like staples. They have little prongs and you push them in and then you bend the prongs. Oops. So those three little leaves from my mom's button box. That's another one of a garment pin with sequins and beads there. And this I thought looked cute. I was sewing on the snaps, and when I went to cut the thread, I thought, I'm just going to leave that little piece of thread there. That looks cool. This is more Natasha's lace and Natasha's little pearl she's got these little pearl dangles in a kit. And that's a little buckle from my mom's scrap box. This is some vintage lace from my mom's. And this is some vintage lace. And this is some vintage lace tatting. This was a little earring also from my mom's jewelry box, and I like to bend the little, it was a stud earring, and I just bend the back and turn it into a loop so that I could sew it on there. I don't know if you can see that. But she loved little Christmas earrings, so that was one of her earrings. And then finally, I had to represent my dad. This was my dad's old Timex. So I just sewed that on there on the end. Phew, done. Okay, so I'm going to go through really slowly, backwards, so that you can see and I have gone on a snippet craze and this is my birthday month and I have been toying with do I do a challenge, do I not do a challenge. I finally found what I'd like to do as a challenge, and I know there's a ton of challenges out there. So I might decide to just wait. I don't know. We'll see. Okay, and we'll do the back one more time. And that is my snippet roll. So I hope that you enjoyed watching. I hope that you have seen maybe some ideas that you might like to try. And I hope you, if you'd like, make a snippet roll. And if you do, please let me know. I'm in a snippet craze right now, so I would love to see the ideas that you come up with for your snippets. And I have a bag of snippets that I recently made that I will be sharing with you in another video. So stay tuned. Thanks for joining my channel. I hope you like my project, Natasha. I had the best time. Thank you so much for all your gorgeous goodies this month. This, as I said, is going to be an heirloom piece for me, and it'll be one that I pass down to my daughters, and hopefully they'll pass down to their daughters. Don't forget, we have the Thank You My Favorite Store Challenge. We've got the Valentine Hop going on. Don't forget to visit the other designers. And we've got lots of stuff going on. So just stay tuned. If you need more information on the hop, please go to Natasha Mynoshka's channel. She has the details there. And all the links will be below. If you'd like to buy any of this goodness and you would like to have a discount on your order, you can use my discount code. It's ROSANNE, all in capital letters, and all that information will be down below in the description box. So thank you so much, everyone, for watching, and until next time, God bless everyone. Bye-bye.